can't take this with you, but you can skim through it, so you've seen it." The report was about as minimalist as the office we were sitting in. All it could add to what I already knew was that Fernando Garrido, identified here by his full name, date of birth and address, had been roaring drunk, that his wife, identified here as Bodil Breheim, had seemed indignant and agitated, that the police patrol unit summoned had done everything in its power to calm tempers, but Garrido had resisted our intervention with such force that ultimately we found ourselves forced to handcuff him and take him to a drunk cell. It also said a charge of assaulting a police officer might be pending, and that Fernando Garrido had, on his own initiative, called a solicitor, Berit Breheim, his sister-in-law, incidentally, and he had been released. "Any further developments in this case?" I asked. Risterson stroked his moustache for a while and shrugged.
"Not as far as I know. It's up to our solicitor to consider the charge, of course. But it was nothing serious, and as the individual concerned had a clean record and no previous involvement with the police, I assume the case will be shelved. I mean, Bolstead and I are not exactly wimps, so he didn't represent a real threat."
"In other words, he didn't injure either of you."
"Does it look like it?"
Risterson grinned. "Did you get an inkling of what might have caused the row?"
"No, but we know who we're dealing with. He was pretty drunk and out of it. She seemed quite stressed. I think I wrote indignant in the report. Either he was jealous or vice versa. That's what often..."
"Vice versa? Was there anything to suggest she'd started the whole business?"
"No, no, I didn't mean it like that. These cases are often about jealousy. Or her spending too much money on clothes and stuff. Or generally that they shouldn't have moved in together. The usual. Then Pops gets plastered, Mumsy gets a sock in the kisser, and the following day they're all lovey-dovey again.